I'm Lindsay from allthenourishingthings.com, and today I'm answering the question, what's the difference between collagen and gelatin? Collagen and gelatin. Unless you've been living under a rock, you've probably seen something about them in your email or your social media feed. Are they a health trend or are they sticking around? I personally think they're sticking around for good. I've been using both collagen and gelatin on a daily basis for over 3 years, and during that time, I've experienced improved gut health, faster hair and nail growth, and amazing skin health. So I'm a fan and I use them all the time and plan to continue doing so. But you might be wondering, what's the difference? Do I need both collagen and gelatin? How am I supposed to use them? Where do I find them and what do I look for? I'm going to be answering those 5 questions in this video. Before we dive into the difference between collagen and gelatin, I first want to explain that they're more similar than they are different. Collagen and gelatin are both made from the same thing, the bones and connective tissues of grass-fed cows. They also have the exact same amino acid profile and the same benefits. Some of the benefits of using collagen and gelatin are improved skin, hair, and nail health. They also can make your hair and nails grow faster. They're great for gut health and healing the gut. They can improve your metabolism. They can reduce joint pain and inflammation and reduce inflammation all over. And they also deliver some amino acids that we might have trouble getting in our everyday diet. So, what's the difference between collagen and gelatin? Well, I want you to think about apples and applesauce. They have the same core ingredient, right? Pun intended. Collagen and gelatin are the same way. Collagen is the same ingredient in both collagen and gelatin. So collagen is made from the connective tissues and bones of grass-fed cows. The difference, however, is like apples and applesauce. Applesauce is made from cooked apples, and gelatin is made from cooked collagen. If you've ever made bone broth, then you've cooked the connective tissues and bones of chickens or cows. And when you refrigerated the bone broth, if you did it correctly, you pull it out of the fridge and it has that jiggle or gel whenever it's cool. That's what gelatin is. So you've made gelatin by cooking the bones and connective tissues, or the collagen, of the animal. So that's the biggest difference. It's in how they're prepared. The other big differences, though, are in how you use them. You can't use gelatin in the same way you use collagen. So, do you need them both? Well, from a health benefit perspective, no, you don't need them both. You could choose one or the other and use it every day as a supplement to improve your gut health or make your hair or nails grow stronger. But if you want to use them in everyday cooking, it's a great idea to keep them both around because you use them for completely different things. For example, collagen will dissolve very easily in both hot and cold liquids. So you could add it to a glass of lemonade or iced tea or even a smoothie, and you'll never be able to tell by the taste, texture, or smell that it's even there. Gelatin, on the other hand, cannot be added to cold drinks or smoothies because it will make them turn into jello. Ask me how I know this. But gelatin has other great uses as well that collagen cannot be used for. For example, if you want to make homemade jello or gummies or marshmallows, or if you like to make cakes and puddings that you want to set, gelatin is a great way to get those things to set, whereas collagen will not do that. So, if you're using them from a health benefit perspective, you could choose one or the other. Personally, I think collagen is more versatile because it can be added to pretty much anything and you can't tell that it's there. If you want to use them in baking and cooking all the time, like you want to bake cakes and muffins with collagen and you also want to make gummies, jello, and marshmallows, then I would keep them both on hand. So, what are you supposed to look for when you're looking for a quality collagen and or gelatin? So, what are some things to look for when you're searching for a high quality collagen and or gelatin product? Well, you can learn a lot from the label. So, check on the label and make sure that it is marked either grass-fed or pasture-raised. That way you know it's coming from a clean source and not from cows that were raised in a confined animal feeding operation. Also, it's very important to check for a non-GMO certification. This means that the cows weren't eating genetically modified corn, soybeans, or other feed with GMOs. Next, it's also really helpful if you care about amino acids to check the label for an amino acid profile. If the amino acid profile isn't listed on the label, however, you should be able to contact the company and they should be able to give you this type of information. Next, if it's important to you, you want to make sure that your collagen and gelatin are lactose and or dairy free. It may not say it on the label, but again, you should be able to contact the company and they can give you this information. Is it pesticide free and hormone free? Does it have added flow agents or fillers? You really want to watch out for things like maltodextrin or starches that are added as a filler. And finally, is it a complete source of protein? And again, you'll know that by checking the amino acid profile. One other thing that you may not be as familiar with, however, is whether it's glyphosate residue free. I recently learned about glyphosate residue free certification from my friends at Perfect Supplements, which is where I get our collagen, gelatin, and many other supplements and superfoods that we use. So if you've ever used a product called Roundup, it's a spray that you can apply to your yard and garden that will kill pests. Many seeds, including corn and soybean seeds, are now being genetically engineered to contain the active ingredient in Roundup, which is glyphosate, so that when the plant sprouts, if an insect or worm tries to eat it, it ingests the glyphosate and dies. This might sound like an inefficient and good idea, except if you think about it, do you really want to be eating something that kills other life? I don't. So, when cows are fed the corn or soybeans or other plants that are engineered with glyphosate, the glyphosate gets into their bodies and then they're butchered and their meat, bones, cartilage, and muscle contains the glyphosate or glyphosate residue. So my friends at Perfect Supplements have taken the pains to have their collagen tested, and it is now the world's only glyphosate residue-free certified collagen. You might be asking about the gelatin. Well, they don't have glyphosate residue-free certification for the gelatin yet, but I know this. Their collagen and gelatin comes from the same place, from the same cows grazing on the same pastures in Brazil and Argentina in South America. So it stands to reason that if their collagen is already glyphosate residue free, it won't be long before they have certification for the gelatin as well. That may be something you've never considered before when thinking about collagen or gelatin. You might have just thought, I want to find the cheapest collagen and gelatin there is just so I can get the health benefits or make gummies or marshmallows or add it to my tea. But I really do encourage you to check for not only GMO-free, organic, paleo, keto, certified, dairy-free, gluten-free, all the free certification. I really encourage you to watch out for glyphosate too. I think it's going to be the next thing that we're all aware of whenever we buy food. So I hope that you've enjoyed this comparison of collagen and gelatin. If you'd like to get some collagen and gelatin for yourself, my friends at Perfect Supplements will give you 10% off your order with my discount code ALLTHETHINGS. That's all capital letters, ALLTHETHINGS. That gets you 10% off any order from Perfect Supplements. I'll have links below this video. Please like and subscribe to my channel so you never miss anything. Thanks so much for watching.